What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. In today's video, we're going to focus on pronunciation of the ED ending, as it causes problems for many students. Are you ready to improve your pronunciation? If so, let's crack on. The rules we're going to look at apply both to adjectives ending in ED and regular verbs in the past. Basically, there are three groups. Let's look at the first group. If the pronunciation of the final sound, not letter, of the infinitive is t or d, and we add ed, the pronunciation is id. For example, wanted, decided, or some adjectives, excited or blinded. So only in this case, we pronounce the letter e. Now let's move on to our second group. If the final sound of the infinitive is unvoiced, it means that there is no vibration of the vocal cords. In this case, the pronunciation of ed would be t. And now let's look at unvoiced sounds. For example, f. Laugh, in the past it would be laughed, or an adjective, stuffed. The sound k, for example, cooked or walked. The sound p, for example, stopped or helped. Sound s, for example, faxed or get dressed. Sound sh, for example, wished or washed. Another sound is ch, for example, watched or switched. And last but not least, the sound th, for example, bathed or unearthed. So in this group, it's really important not to pronounce the letter E, so we wouldn't say stop it, but stopped. And to finish the third group, if the final sound of the infinitive is voiced, it means that there is vibration of the vocal cords. In this case, the pronunciation of ed is d, so basically is the rest of the sounds. And now let's look at the voiced sounds. So the sound v, it would be lived or loved. So the same, we don't pronounce the letter e, and the final sound is d. The sound g, for example, begged or egged on. The meaning of to egg on is to encourage. The sound b, for example, grabbed or disturbed. The sound z, used or refused. The sound j, for example, changed or encouraged. Next sound, the sound v, theta forte, v, for example, smoothed or breathed. The sound j, for example, massaged. Let's move on to the sound m, for example, climbed or seemed. Also the sound n, for example, phoned or designed. The sound n, and nasal, n, so it would be band, for example, or singed. Also the sound l, for example, traveled or strolled. The sound r, for example, cleared or hired. The sound y, for example, stayed or destroyed. And now I'd like to mention one fun thing, that sometimes the word can be an adjective and at the same time a verb finishing in ed, and the pronunciation would be different. For example, blessed, it would be pronounced with the final t if it's a verb, blessed, but if it's an adjective, it would be pronounced with it, blessed. The same happens with beloved. So the same, if it's in the past, it would be beloved, and if it's an adjective, it would be beloved. For example, a beloved friend. The same happens with crook. If it's a verb, it would be crooked, and if it's an adjective, it would be crooked. For example, a crooked house. The same happens with learned. So the same, if it's a verb, it would be learned. If it's an adjective, it would be learned. And another example, aged, if it's a verb, aged, And if it's an adjective, it would be with it, aged. And also, it's important to point out that if there is no corresponding verb, the pronunciation is always it. For example, naked, or wicked, or sacred. So I really hope you found this English bit useful, and it will help you avoid making this quite common pronunciation mistake. And of course, if you liked this English bit, don't forget to give it the thumbs up and to subscribe to the channel. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao!